In the old days, charcoal was widely used as a household fuel, but the advent of gas and electricity pretty much brought an end to that. Nevertheless, charcoal did continue to be used occasionally, and sometimes in surprising circumstances. Take a look at this. This picture was taken in the 1930s, and it shows a charcoal-powered bus. The bus ran on carbon monoxide produced by burning charcoal, instead of using petrol. During the Second World War, Japan suffered from a severe energy shortage. Petrol was all devoted to military uses, and charcoal was adopted as an alternative. It takes a lot of time to generate gas from charcoal, but there are other disadvantages too. Charcoal-powered engines have less horsepower than petrol engines, and they tend to stall. But fuel shortages continued for some years after the war's end, and charcoal buses were still running in the early 1950s. With Japan's eventual post-war recovery, coal and oil became widely available again, and charcoal abruptly vanished from daily life. These days, especially in urban areas, you'll rarely see charcoal used as a fuel. But in some parts of Japan, it still remains important to the local way of life.
The Nakanomata district of Joetsu City in Niigata Prefecture is a tiny hamlet of 53 households. During the winter, it's blanketed in deep snow. The houses here have old-fashioned hearths, where charcoal is still used for cooking and heating. On a clear winter day, smoke wafts from the flank of the mountain. It comes from a charcoal-making hut. Yoshio Kitajima is charring wood in this hut. His face drips with sweat as he tends the flames and rakes glowing hot charcoal from the kiln. Kitajima's family has operated this hut for three generations. In the past, almost every household in the community made charcoal, but now the Kitajimas are the only one. Ashes are shoveled promptly onto the charcoal by Kitajima's wife, Nobu. Husband and wife work in sync. It's easier to do it together than alone. You know. He loves doing it, so as long as he does it, I'm along for the ride. Hefting a load of charcoal, Nobu makes the rounds in the village. She's delivering gifts of charcoal. Around half of the charcoal that the couple produces consists of broken pieces that aren't suitable for sale. The Kitajimas distribute this charcoal to their neighbors. It's great stuff, a treasure. I'm very grateful. Next, Nobu pays a visit to Masae Kawasaki. Please use this. Oh, thank you so much. Masae is a childhood friend of Nobu's. The Kawasakis used to make charcoal too, but 15 years ago, Masai's husband died. It wasn't possible for her to continue making charcoal alone. She now lives by herself. Nobu occasionally comes to check on Masae, bringing her some charcoal. Nobu has her own teacup here set aside by Masae. The two women enjoy a cup of tea together. Nobu is rarely happier than when she's here drinking tea with her friend. She'll ask me to bring more, and I will. I want her to use a lot. During the winter, no farming can be done in Nakanomata. At every chance, the villagers will gather at one of their homes to enjoy friendly conversation. Everyone brings food along. It's all unfussy family fare. like rice balls browned on the charcoal hearth. Nothing fancy, just a lot of comfort food. The Kitajimas are at home chatting with old friends. In this land of deep snows, the villagers enjoy these gatherings as they wait for spring. And charcoal is a source of warmth for both their bodies and their souls.
This is a charcoal dealer which stocks most of the main types of charcoal that are used in Japan these days. And I have three basic types here in front of me. This is black charcoal, the most common, and it also lights the easiest. This is so-called white charcoal, which you saw in the video. It's not really white, there's a sort of grayish tinge to it, but it does have white specks which come from the ash which is used when it's made. And this is bamboo charcoal. Bamboo is extremely plentiful in Japan. It also grows extremely quickly. Charcoal also has other uses apart from as a fuel. If you look at this table here under the glass, you'll see examples of some very interesting ornamental charcoal. For example, it's a chestnut, and next to it here, it's made from a tangerine. You can even make charcoal out of coffee beans if you look over here. And behind me, over here, this is a wind chime. If you have that hanging in your window, it would make a very nice sound on a summer day. And there are quite a number of other charcoal-related products, including soap. I know what you're thinking, but it's not a joke either. There's charcoal shampoo, and there's even charcoal toothpaste. And then down here we have, I wonder if you can guess what these are. It's kind of like a cocktail stick. You swizzle around your whiskey and soda or whatever it is you like to have. Probably best to leave it in there for a couple of hours, but it's kind of fun anyway. And what all of these products have in common is that they take advantage of the special properties of charcoal. More about those now in our next video.
Charcoal's uses are many and varied. At this house being built, 1,500 kilograms of charcoal are laid beneath the floorboards to regulate moisture. Charcoal has moisture-absorbing properties. The interior of a piece of charcoal is riddled with small pores that create a surface area of between 200 and 400 square meters per gram. Moisture is trapped by these pores. Charcoal will not only absorb moisture beneath the floor, but release it when the climate is dry, helping to maintain the house's humidity level throughout the year. Charcoal is also handy for preserving vegetables and fruits. When placed in a refrigerator, it absorbs the ethylene gas released by vegetables, meaning they'll keep longer. Farmers use charcoal too. Mixed with soil, it helps to maintain an optimal level of moisture, and the microbes inside its tiny pores promote the growth of agricultural products. Charcoal is reported to boost yields of many vegetables, including lettuce and cabbage. Adding a lump of charcoal when cooking rice makes it fluffier. This is attributed to charcoal's mineral content. Its sodium and potassium begin to dissolve and act on the amylase in the rice, causing the grains to swell. And charcoal is useful even beyond the charcoal itself. The smoke from charcoal making is condensed to make wood vinegar, which can be purified and used as a detoxifier, pest repellent, and preservative. Here it's used in a bath, where it's reputed to help the heat of the water to penetrate to the bone. Diluted wood vinegar can also be applied to fields to keep pests off crops. Here's a story about another interesting use. At dusk, a flock of starlings swarms above the streets. They roost in vast numbers on street trees from summer through autumn. The flocks grow even larger after the bird's breeding season, as autumn turns to winter. Their noise and droppings are a major nuisance in many urban areas. Hidenori Miyabara, a resident of Nagano City, hit upon the idea of using wood vinegar to deter them. As Miyabara was transferring wood vinegar between containers beneath a tree where the birds often roosted, he noticed something. When I was transferring the stuff under that tree, the birds didn't come. Miyabara approached a city employee about his idea, and an experiment was conducted. A container of wood vinegar is hung from every tree. The distinctive odor wafts out from holes in the containers. Dusk. The flock of starlings begins to gather. But not a single one roosts in the street's trees. None came today. It was a complete success. Not only charcoal itself, but also its byproducts are now being used in more and more ways.
In the past, charcoal was made all over Japan. Wood would be cut from the forest, charred into charcoal, then new trees would grow, and the cycle would continue. And this symbiotic relationship also promoted forest management and preservation of the landscape. Unfortunately, charcoal has almost completely come to an end now in its role as a fuel in Japan. But I can't think of any other country that's found so many alternative uses for charcoal. We'll leave you now with a look at another way in which charcoal has been used in Japan for many years, and which has very little to do with everyday life. I'll see you again next time.
The cross-section of this type of charcoal log resembles a chrysanthemum, which is why it's called chrysanthemum charcoal. Chrysanthemum charcoal plays a part in the 400-year tradition of the tea ceremony. This is a tea gathering of the Urasenke school. The host welcomes his guests by making tea according to rituals that embody the spirit of hospitality. Pieces of chrysanthemum charcoal are neatly arranged. As the host places them in the hearth, the guests observe his stylized movements and the beauty of the charcoal. This procedure is an important element of the tea ceremony. The charcoal is arranged with the thicker pieces at the bottom and the slender ones on top. Together, they represent a growing tree. In the tea ceremony, charcoal is more than just a fuel. It also conveys a love of nature. Next time, rain. Japan receives twice as much rain as the average country. It's an essential part of Japanese life, but it also presents various problems. We'll see how the Japanese view and deal with rain.
In the old days, charcoal was widely used as a household fuel, but the advent of gas and electricity pretty much brought an end to that. Nevertheless, charcoal did continue to be used occasionally, and sometimes in surprising circumstances. Take a look at this. This picture was taken in the 1930s and it shows a charcoal-powered bus. The bus ran on carbon monoxide produced by burning charcoal instead of using petrol. During the Second World War, Japan suffered from a severe energy shortage. Petrol was all devoted to military uses and charcoal was adopted as an alternative. It takes a lot of time to generate gas from charcoal, but there are other disadvantages too. Charcoal-powered engines have less horsepower than petrol engines, and they tend to stall. But fuel shortages continued for some years after the war's end, and charcoal buses were still running in the early 1950s. With Japan's eventual post-war recovery, coal and oil became widely available again, and charcoal abruptly vanished from daily life. These days, especially in urban areas, you'll rarely see charcoal used as a fuel. But in some parts of Japan, it still remains important to the local way of life.
The Nakanomata district of Joetsu City in Niigata Prefecture is a tiny hamlet of 53 households. During the winter, it's blanketed in deep snow. The houses here have old-fashioned hearths, where charcoal is still used for cooking and heating. On a clear winter day, smoke wafts from the flank of the mountain. It comes from a charcoal-making hut. Yoshio Kitajima is charring wood in this hut. His face drips with sweat as he tends the flames and rakes glowing hot charcoal from the kiln. Kitajima's family has operated this hut for three generations. In the past, almost every household in the community made charcoal. But now the Kitajimas are the only one. Ashes are shoveled promptly onto the charcoal by Kitajima's wife, Nobu. Husband and wife work in sync. It's easier to do it together than alone. You know. He loves doing it, so as long as he does it, I'm along for the ride. Hefting a load of charcoal, Nobu makes the rounds in the village. She's delivering gifts of charcoal. Around half of the charcoal that the couple produces consists of broken pieces that aren't suitable for sale. The Kitajimas distribute this charcoal to their neighbors. It's great stuff, a treasure. I'm very grateful. Next, Nobu pays a visit to Masae Kawasaki. Please use this. Oh, thank you so much. Masae is a childhood friend of Nobu's. The Kawasakis used to make charcoal too, but 15 years ago, Masai's husband died. It wasn't possible for her to continue making charcoal alone. She now lives by herself. Nobu occasionally comes to check on Masae, bringing her some charcoal. Nobu has her own teacup here set aside by Masae. The two women enjoy a cup of tea together. Nobu is rarely happier than when she's here drinking tea with her friend. She'll ask me to bring more and I will. I want her to use a lot. During the winter, no farming can be done in Nakanomata. At every chance, the villagers will gather at one of their homes to enjoy friendly conversation. Everyone brings food along. It's all unfussy family fare, like rice balls browned on the charcoal hearth. Nothing fancy, just a lot of comfort food. The Kitajimas are at home chatting with old friends. In this land of deep snows, the villagers enjoy these gatherings as they wait for spring. And charcoal is a source of warmth for both their bodies and their souls.
This is a charcoal dealer which stocks most of the main types of charcoal that are used in Japan these days. And I have three basic types here in front of me. This is black charcoal, the most common, and it also lights the easiest. This is so-called white charcoal, which you saw in the video. It's not really white, there's a sort of greyish tinge to it, but it does have white specks which come from the ash which is used when it's made. And this is bamboo charcoal. Bamboo is extremely plentiful in Japan. It also grows extremely quickly. Charcoal also has other uses apart from as a fuel. If you look at this table here under the glass, you'll see examples of some very interesting ornamental charcoal. For example, it's a chestnut, and next to it here, it's made from a tangerine. You can even make charcoal out of coffee beans if you look over here. And behind me, over here, this is a wind chime. If you have that hanging in your window, it would make a very nice sound on a summer day. And there are quite a number of other charcoal-related products, including soap. I know what you're thinking, but it's not a joke either. There's charcoal shampoo, and there's even charcoal toothpaste. And then down here we have, I wonder if you can guess what these are. It's kind of like a cocktail stick. You swizzle around your whiskey and soda or whatever it is you like to have. Probably best to leave it in there for a couple of hours, but it's kind of fun anyway. And what all of these products have in common is that they take advantage...
...resident of Nagano City hit upon the idea of using wood vinegar to deter them. As Miyabara was transferring wood vinegar between containers beneath a tree where the birds often roosted, he noticed something. When I was transferring the stuff under that tree, the birds didn't come. Miyabara approached a city employee about his idea, and an experiment was conducted. A container of wood vinegar is hung from every tree. The distinctive odor wafts out from holes in the containers. Dusk. The flock of starlings begins to gather. But not a single one roosts in the street's trees. None came today. It was a complete success. Not only charcoal itself, but also its byproducts are now being used in more and more ways.
In the past, charcoal was made all over Japan. Wood would be cut from the forest, charred into charcoal, then new trees would grow, and the cycle would continue. And this symbiotic relationship also promoted forest management and preservation of the landscape. Unfortunately, charcoal has almost completely come to an end now in its role as a fuel in Japan. But I can't think of any other country that's found so many alternative uses for charcoal. We'll leave you now with a look at another way in which charcoal has been used in Japan for many years, and which has very little to do with everyday life. I'll see you again next time.
The cross-section of this type of charcoal log resembles a chrysanthemum, which is why it's called chrysanthemum charcoal. Chrysanthemum charcoal plays a part in the 400-year tradition of the tea ceremony. This is a tea gathering of the Urasenke school. The host welcomes his guests by making tea according to rituals that embody the spirit of hospitality. Pieces of chrysanthemum charcoal are neatly arranged. As the host places them in the hearth, the guests observe his stylized movements and the beauty of the charcoal. This procedure is an important element of the tea ceremony. The charcoal is arranged with the thicker pieces at the bottom and the slender ones on top. Together, they represent a growing tree. In the tea ceremony, charcoal is more than just a fuel. It also conveys a love of nature. Next time, rain. Japan receives twice as much rain as the average country. It's an essential part of Japanese life, but it also presents various problems. We'll see how the Japanese view and deal with rain.
In the old days, charcoal was widely used as a household fuel, but the advent of gas and electricity pretty much brought an end to that. Nevertheless, charcoal did continue to be used occasionally, and sometimes in surprising circumstances. Take a look at this. This picture was taken in the 1930s, and it shows a charcoal-powered bus. The bus ran on carbon monoxide produced by burning charcoal instead of using petrol. During the Second World War, Japan suffered from a severe energy shortage. Petrol was all devoted to military uses, and charcoal was adopted as an alternative. It takes a lot of time to generate gas from charcoal, but there are other disadvantages too. Charcoal-powered engines have less horsepower than petrol engines, and they tend to stall. But fuel shortages continued for some years after the war's end, and charcoal buses were still running in the early 1950s. With Japan's eventual post-war recovery, coal and oil became widely available again, and charcoal abruptly vanished from daily life. These days, especially in urban areas, you'll rarely see charcoal used as a fuel. But in some parts of Japan, it still remains important to the local way of life.
The Nakanomata district of Joetsu City in Niigata Prefecture is a tiny hamlet of 53 households. During the winter, it's blanketed in deep snow. The houses here have old-fashioned hearths, where charcoal is still used for cooking and heating. On a clear winter day, smoke wafts from the flank of the mountain. It comes from a charcoal-making hut. Yoshio Kitajima is charring wood in this hut. His face drips with sweat as he tends the flames and rakes glowing hot charcoal from the kiln. Kitajima's family has operated this hut for three generations. In the past, almost every household in the community made charcoal. But now the Kitajimas are the only one. Ashes are shoveled promptly onto the charcoal by Kitajima's wife, Nobu. Husband and wife work in sync. It's easier to do it together than alone. You know. He loves doing it, so as long as he does it, I'm along for the ride. Hefting a load of charcoal, Nobu makes the rounds in the village. She's delivering gifts of charcoal. Around half of the charcoal that the couple produces consists of broken pieces that aren't suitable for sale. The Kitajimas distribute this charcoal to their neighbors. It's
drinking, but it's not a joke either. There's charcoal shampoo, and there's even charcoal toothpaste. And then down here we have, I wonder if you can guess what these are. It's kind of like a cocktail stick. You swizzle around your whiskey and soda, or whatever it is you like to have. Probably best to leave it in there for a couple of hours, but it's kind of fun anyway. And what all of these products have in common is that they take advantage of the special properties of charcoal. More about those now in our next video.
Charcoal's uses are many and varied. At this house being built, 1,500 kilograms of charcoal are laid beneath the floorboards to regulate moisture. Charcoal has moisture-absorbing properties. The interior of a piece of charcoal is riddled with small pores that create a surface area of between 200 and 400 square meters per gram. Moisture is trapped by these pores. Charcoal will not only absorb moisture beneath the floor, but release it when the climate is dry, helping to maintain the house's humidity level throughout the year. Charcoal is also handy for preserving vegetables and fruits. When placed in a refrigerator, it absorbs the ethylene gas released by vegetables, meaning they'll keep longer. Farmers use charcoal too. Mixed with soil, it helps to maintain an optimal level of moisture and the microbes inside its tiny pores promote the growth of agricultural products. Charcoal is reported to boost yields of many vegetables, including lettuce and cabbage. Adding a lump of charcoal when cooking rice makes it fluffier. This is attributed to charcoal's mineral content. Its sodium and potassium begin to dissolve and act on the amylase in the rice, causing the grains to swell. And charcoal is useful even beyond the charcoal itself. The smoke from charcoal making is condensed to make wood vinegar, which can be purified and used as a detoxifier, pest repellent, and preservative. Here it's used in a bath, where it's reputed to help the heat of the water to penetrate to the bone. Diluted wood vinegar can also be applied to fields to keep pests off crops. Here's a story about another interesting use. At dusk, a flock of starlings swarms above the streets. They roost in vast numbers on street trees from summer through autumn. The flocks grow even larger after the birds' breeding season, as autumn turns to winter. Their noise and droppings are a major nuisance in many urban areas. Hidenori Miyabara, a resinibus. It's great stuff, a treasure. I'm very grateful. Next, Nobu pays a visit to Masai Kawasaki. Please use this. Oh, thank you so much. Masai is a childhood friend of Nobu's. The Kawasakis used to make charcoal too, but 15 years ago, Masai's husband died. It wasn't possible for her to continue making charcoal alone. She now lives by herself. Nobu occasionally comes to check on Masai, bringing her some charcoal. Nobu has her own teacup here set aside by Masai. The two women enjoy a cup of tea together. Nobu is rarely happier than when she's here drinking tea with her friend. She'll ask me to bring more, and I will. I want her to use a lot. During the winter, no farming can be done in Nakanomata. At every chance, the villagers will gather at one of their homes to enjoy friendly conversation. Everyone brings food along. It's all unfussy family fare, like rice balls browned on the charcoal hearth. Nothing fancy, just a lot of comfort food. The Kitajimas are at home chatting with old friends. In this land of deep snows, the villagers enjoy these gatherings as they wait for spring. And charcoal is a source of warmth for both their bodies and their souls.
This is a charcoal dealer which stocks most of the main types of charcoal that are used in Japan these days. And I have three basic types here in front of me. This is black charcoal, the most common, and it also lights the easiest. This is so-called white charcoal, which you saw in the video. It's not really white, there's a sort of grayish tinge to it, but it does have white specks which come from the ash which is used when it's made. And this is bamboo charcoal. Bamboo is extremely plentiful in Japan. It also grows extremely quickly. Charcoal also has other uses apart from as a fuel. If you look at this table here under the glass, you'll see examples of some very interesting ornamental charcoal. For example, it's a chestnut, and next to it here, it's made from a tangerine, You can even make charcoal out of coffee beans if you look over here. And behind me, over here, this is a wind chime. If you have that hanging in your window, it would make a very nice sound on a summer day. And there are quite a number of other charcoal-related products, including soap. I know what you're thinking. In the old days, charcoal was widely used as a household fuel, but the advent of gas and electricity pretty much brought an end to that. Nevertheless, charcoal did continue to be used occasionally, and sometimes in surprising circumstances. Take a look at this. This picture was taken in the 1930s, and it shows a charcoal-powered bus. The bus ran on carbon monoxide produced by burning charcoal instead of using petrol. During the Second World War, Japan suffered from a severe energy shortage. Petrol was all devoted to military uses, and charcoal was adopted as an alternative. It takes a lot of time to generate gas from charcoal, but there are other disadvantages too. Charcoal-powered engines have less horsepower than petrol engines, and they tend to stall. But fuel shortages continued for some years after the war's end, and charcoal buses were still running in the early 1950s. With Japan's eventual post-war recovery, coal and oil became widely available again, and charcoal abruptly vanished from daily life. These days, especially in urban areas, you'll rarely see charcoal used as a fuel. But in some parts of Japan, it still remains important to the local way of life.
The Nakanomata district of Joetsu City in Niigata Prefecture is a tiny hamlet of 53 households. During the winter, it's blanketed in deep snow. The houses here have old-fashioned hearths, where charcoal is still used for cooking and heating. On a clear winter day, smoke wafts from the flank of the mountain. It comes from a charcoal-making hut. Yoshio Kitajima is charring wood in this hut. His face drips with sweat as he tends the flames and rakes glowing hot charcoal from the kiln. Kitajima's family has operated this hut for three generations. In the past, almost every household in the community made charcoal. But now the Kitajimas are the only one. Ashes are shoveled promptly onto the charcoal by Kitajima's wife, Nobu. Husband and wife work in sync. It's easier to do it together than alone. You know. He loves doing it, so as long as he does it, I'm along for the ride. Hefting a load of charcoal, Nobu makes the rounds in the village. She's delivering gifts of charcoal. Around half of the charcoal that the couple produces consists of broken pieces that aren't suitable for sale. The Kitajimas distribute this charcoal to their neighbors.